Hi viewers, welcome back to Sumita's Tasty Food Channel. Today I came with another new recipe, that is paneer pistachio koftas. These paneer koftas goes well with roti, paratha, naan and rice. So let's see what are the ingredients we require. Here I've taken 2 tablespoons of pista, soaking in warm water to soften them. On the other hand, I'm taking here approximately 200 grams of cottage cheese. This is homemade cottage cheese. See the recipe link in the above iCard. Now we will break this paneer and knead until the paneer gathers all together to make a soft and smooth dough. You can knead it faster with the help of your heel of your hand. That really works, and when you feel the paneer became softer, that's when you can add 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda and 3 tablespoons of corn flour and salt to taste. Mix all these things together in order to incorporate together very well. Here I'm adding 1 tablespoon of water just to make little softer. Then we are gonna divide this portion into 2 parts. Take out the 1/3 portion of it. Now we will chop these pista nuts to add into that 1/3 portion of our paneer. We are going to add pista nuts into this 1/3 portion and some color. Now make this portion into small balls. Now we will use the white paneer which we kept it aside for rolling these pista balls. As you can see, they're rolling in the video. Repeat the same process with the rest all balls, and now these balls are ready. These are ready for frying. Fry them on medium flame. Guys, I post 2 videos per week, so please keep watching and hit the bell icon so that you'll get the notification. I usually concentrate on national and international recipes. Comment me and tell me what type of recipes you are looking for. Definitely I'll try to post them. Our paneer koftas are ready. Now let's go to our tempering. I am chopping here 3 onions. Here I am taking 3.5 tablespoons of vegetable oil. Once the oil is hot, add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds. When they start to splutter, add onions and saute it until it becomes translucent. While our onions are sauteing, on the other hand, we can blanch our tomatoes. Here I've taken 3 tomatoes. Blanch them on medium flame. When the onions are turning into brown, add 1/2 teaspoon of chili paste. Here I'm adding 3/4 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and saute it until the raw smell is gone completely. While it is frying, let's have a look on our tomatoes which we kept it for blanching. Our tomatoes are ready to peel out the skin. I'm gonna blend these tomatoes into puree. Let's come back to our onions. It's time to add our 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder, followed by 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder and 1/2 teaspoon of dhania powder. Saute it. Then add our prepared tomato puree. To change the consistency of this curry, we may use some water. So instead of using water, you can use the whey. If you had made freshly homemade paneer, then definitely you will get a whey out of it. So you can use that whey, or else you can use a simply plain water. Add some salt to taste and keep the lid on and cook it for some time. While this puree is cooking, we will roast 1 tablespoon of poppy seeds and grind it into a fine powder. Let's come back to our curry. I'm adding here 1/3 cup of boiled peas, followed by our ground poppy seed powder, and then add 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala. Saute it for some time. Finally, when you see the oil is coming up, that's when you can add 2.5 tablespoons of fresh cream, followed by some coriander. That's it. Our paneer pistachio kofta gravy is ready. Let's transfer this gravy into the serving bowl. Finally, we'll garnish with the koftas. That's it. If you like my recipe, please hit the subscribe button and share with others. Thank you so much for watching. Until I see you next time, take care. Bye-bye.